weight cutting can put women into some really nasty areas with like things like what's called FATS or FATS, which is female athlete triad syndrome, which has to do with it's like the easiest way to put it, I guess, is it's like this really heavy stressor on the body from excessive dieting and weight loss, and can really completely screw up their hormone cycles. And you'll see female athletes lose their periods, which, you know, that can happen just from being really lean. But if they are suffering from something like FATS, and I had this happen with an athlete where I set out a diet, a whole program for them, a lifting program, a diet program, and everything for body composition. They didn't necessarily need to lose anyway. But if they were to stick to this program, it was to help them with their strength goals, develop more lean mass while reducing their body fat potentially, but that wasn't really the point. And we weren't really looking for specific weight management. It was just towards athletic potential. And although it's more common in female athletes, they often undereat. It happens both ways, especially when you have to make weight classes. Mm. And being always having that in the back of your head that I don't want to get so far out of the range of weight class. And if I do, you know, the worry about being able to bring it back in. And you know, you have to have a lot of trust and a lot of confidence at the end of the day, not just in yourself, but also in your coaching, your coaches and coaching staff to deliver. If they say, hey, yeah, you're going to go up to X amount of weight, but then when we alter your diet a little bit and then your training load goes up, your weight will come down and it'll be fine. But anyways, I had this female athlete and she was great. You know, she was making her weight class every time. She was good and fit, and, you know, just we're working on getting stronger and being more as best of an athlete as we could. And, you know, I'm watching them over time and go, okay, well, if they're doing the lifts and the training like they're supposed to, and they say they are, then I should be seeing a difference even physically. I should be able to notice it. And number two, if they're eating the way that they're supposed to, I should. So, but I'm not seeing this. In fact, they're kind of staying the same. And eventually I had to force them to give me a diet journal. And when I got 1 week worth of what they were doing, they were hitting all their training sessions with me, and they were doing all their training sessions outside of this for the strength and conditioning stuff. But their eating was half of what they were supposed to. And they did this long enough that when we tried to readjust things back to how they were, we weren't getting any results. Oh. And eventually I had to look into more literature and go, oh, okay, this is what we're dealing with. Her cycle's all screwed up, and I'm like, well, okay, that's strange. And then I'm looking into other aspects of how her, what kind of lethargy and fatigue she's getting, and, you know, whether or not how she's feeling in these workouts. And eventually it's like, okay, yeah, she's got female athlete triad syndrome. And now it's going to take us months to get her body to stop freaking out and thinking that it's possibly going to starve to death or whatever. Right. And over time it managed to correct itself. But if you're an athlete and your time is already limited to where you can be an athlete and go out and compete at your best, and now you've been working towards something, let's say, you've been competing, maybe you've been winning your fights or your bouts, and now you're trying to advance to the next order of where your competition is, and now you're sidelined because all of your natural hormone levels are all over the place. Your body is freaking out. Okay, well, now you ain't going to make weight, because that, even if you could, that's only going to make it worse. And number two, your body has to have time now to recover. And this recovery is not going to be like recovering from sore muscles. This is getting all of your glandular and all these other systems to work right again. So
how does that happen? You know, what is the process of that?
Well, supplementation can be used to help target that, but the main thing is you gotta reduce the intensity of all the training. You gotta make sure that they're eating well enough and that their body is getting enough nutrients so that it gives itself some time to reset. But you don't know how long it's gonna take exactly. And every case can be different. Every case of it can have more or less intensity.
So what
is these are just things you would never know. You would never think about that, right? Yeah. But men can easily screw themselves up with overtraining. I don't mean overtraining in the more typical sense, but I mean, let's say overtraining and undereating. You know, you can do a lot of damage to yourself that way, but it's just different for females. And they have, their hormonal cycles every month they have to consider as well.